inscriptions in Elder speech. Salvation lies not in Dol Nevda, but in our hearts. Glory be to Eldarin. Damn, Professor's journal's long gone. Guess somebody else found out about it too. Should look around, see if I can find something else. Professor certainly can't do much to help me with my search. Footprints, narrow and shallow. Somebody small, light. Woman, maybe? Wonder where they lead. Damn it, trail breaks off. Wonder if the Grave Robber learned more than I did. Won't learn anything else here. Map Yen sent me will have to do. Also, Epitaph mentioned both Eldarin and Dol Nevda, Valley of the Nine. Site marked on the map's all wet now. Sonratour flows through there. Must be where the Valley of the Nine once lay. Need to explore the location. Robber must have found something in Moreau's tomb to activate the entry portal. Wonder what surprises this place has in store. Spikes. Sick sense of humor someone's got. besides me might be ferreting around here. Someone slim. No way I can sling through there. Need to find a way around.
Whoa.
blood-soaked. Grave Robber was wounded while attempting the climb, needed to bandage up. Managed to avoid the Panthers, at least. Whoever was here must have scaled that wall, evaded the Panthers. Not bad. Wouldn't mind having something like that myself. Course. Locked. Notes I found mention 4 protruding stones. Gotta press them somehow. Crossbow, maybe? Could try to hit them.
Did it.
Interesting as places go. Seems someone put a lot of thought into its design. Should look around. This just keeps getting better. Right, now to find the next portal. where I started. Must be where Moreau had his lab. Guessing this man didn't come here willingly. Intriguing as machinery goes, but how do I start it up? And genetics. Preserved organs. Hope their donors weren't forced to give them up. Crystals. Should mount them in the megascope. Missing two crystals. Just need to pick an entry.
The 18th of Yule, year 1102. Today I begin my great life's endeavor, one greater and more significant than any I have thus far undertaken, for it relates to me personally, to myself and my son. When 15 years passed, a beast of the forest assaulted me. A witcher came to my aid, saved my life. I could not know that for said salvation, I would in the end pay by relinquishing any say as to my own son's fate. Had I the skill to turn back time, I would have done so, and perished rather than surrender to the Witcher's my only son. But as it was, on the day when Jerome was taken, I swore an oath on my honor that I would recover my son. Today, following years of research and preparation, I have at last devised a device that allows me to study mutations. If the gods in their goodness grant me but a bit of favor, I shall find a way to reverse said mutations and restore Jerome to a normal life.
So, Professor wasn't out to enhance Witcher mutations, wanted to reverse them. Wonder if he managed, and if there's anything in it for me.
Observation 22. Despite applying a surfeit of toxic substances, significantly more than usual, the subject displayed no symptoms of overdosing. I believe this to be an effect of the mutations. Thus, a minor success. This mutation should allow Jerome better to tolerate toxicity. Observation number 30. The mutations do not set in at once. Curiously, they do not develop over a span of time. Rather, for a mutation to progress towards completion, the appropriate mutagen must be applied continuously. The subject does not bear this well, but I found a way to make the mutations less taxing, invasive. To the mutagen base, I add the albumin of a mutated giant centipede egg. Stored in a glass terrarium, the eggs do not develop. Remain small. The eggs themselves are a sight to behold. Mutated, they are luminescent, emitting a wondrous glow. I can only hope my addition of the albumin will produce no significant side effects. Time will tell. Observation 58. Sometimes failure is the catalyst for success. I've discovered a method by which one type of mutagen may be transmuted into another through the addition of certain ingredients. This is a great day for science. In addition, I observed that today's dose of mutagens brought the subject to the brink of death. He then suddenly awoke, revived, his strength renewed. Not wholly, of course. But he did, in a sense, come back from the edge of death. Whether this is attributable to his mutations or to pure coincidence cannot be ascertained. I must conduct further experiments. Years of experiments, research, sacrifice, all for naught. I have failed to achieve my defined objective. Each mutation I applied to my subjects proved ineffective when applied to Jerome. What I meant to cure him of his witcherism, that which I meant to restore to him a normal life, only deepened his mutations, further augmented his speed and strength, rendered him yet more inhuman. It seems my son must remain a witcher forever. I have failed. The time has come to abandon this place. Return home to Lydia. She may yet deign to take me back. The contraption and mutagens I leave here. Let them wither and crumble. As did my dreams of regaining my son.
So the professor wanted to reverse the mutation's effects. Ended up deepening them. Stroke of luck for me. Could profit from his failure. So, Professor tried to neutralize the effects of Witcher mutations. Only managed to enhance them, though. Used the albumens of giant centipede eggs as his mutagen base. Need to go on an egg hunt. Intriguing as machinery mutagens might work on me as they do on his son. Well, time to find out. herself or portals. Feels dead. Maybe a sign will revive it.